My name is Philip John. I'm the director of Moondogs. It's my first feature. When I was a kid, I used to make an unholy row in my garden shed. So I was really into the music, and also I was completely terrible with women. So two characters, one's a music genius, I wasn't a genius. The other guy was terrible with women, I was terrible with women. So I managed to sort of slot a fair bit of grim autobiographical detail into our writer's story. We had a completely different cast at the start of the process. We thought we had a window to make the film, so we casted up three wonderful actors, and then we lost them because the money went. So then we had another window about a year later, and we thought, right, we need to cast this quickly. There's a possibility this could go in the summer. And so we started looking, and we had money from Wales, Ireland, and Scotland, so we had to cast from Wales, Ireland, and Scotland. First guy we cast, Jack, parry-jones, I saw his self-tape, it was beautiful. He was a brand new actor, straight out of RADA, done nothing. But he just did the most beautiful things with the dialogue. And casting, you know, it's like 99% of the work. If you can cast that character, if you find someone like Jack who's emotionally transparent and funny, great comic timing. So we cast him, and then we went to Ireland to try and find Kathleen. We needed someone a bit like Debbie Harry, rude, insolent, and we found her. Tara Lee's got the most amazing singing voice, and she just doesn't give a we had a hole in the script. We had two boys who were really well written, but the female, we needed this like feral, author of her own life kind of nomad, and Tara just popped up and just became that role, and she was amazing. Our biggest problem was trying to cast Thor. Thor is a bit of a music genius, and you know, can you imagine trying to find someone who can play any instrument, Scottish, and not busy? And so we ended up, eventually I saw, we had nobody, like the Friday before we were due to shoot, we had nobody to play Thor. And then I remember seeing this tiny little self-tape of this boy who looked like he had Asperger's or something. He was incredibly intense and wouldn't speak. And so I thought, right, let's bring him in. Maybe we can use him. We can, something we can do. And he walks in and he brings a guitar with him and he just doesn't stop talking. I thought, what's this? What's going on? And then I said, look, stop talking. Just get your guitar out. So he said, okay, so I'm going to get my guitar out. And he looked at the producer and the casting director and he said, right, ladies, I'm going to seduce you now. And I thought, oh, God, he's a moron. There's nothing we can do. What can we do? And then he sang, but he did seduce all of us because he was just beautiful, and his voice was amazing, and he just had the most kind of real quality. And then suddenly we were cast, and we didn't really put them together to see what the chemistry was like, because I knew it would be great, and indeed it was. Well, I needed Thor's sonic identity, and I have a thing where I don't really go to composers because they'll give me a version of something. So I generally go to artists I'm really big fans of, and Anton Newcombe was somebody I'd listened to for years. And I just emailed him, and he was like, yeah, I'll do it. And I couldn't have been happier, because his music is like 50% of the film. It's extraordinary and full of fire and soul, and he made Thor's music completely authentic, you know, because Anton is a proper genius. So we struck it lucky, really. Locations, they were in the script, Shetland, Glasgow. I thought we were going to hire a coach. That's what I thought. I thought we'd get a bus, we put all the gear on it, we had the editing suites, we'd drive down from Shetland through Aberdeenshire, down through Scotland to Glasgow. No. We had 2 days in Glasgow, and then the rest of the time was about 10 miles around, 2 days in Shetland, and the rest of the time around Glasgow, trying to find locations that we could put four or five different places in. So we had to make the money stretch, because we didn't have enough.